我们又荣幸地邀请到了圣巴蒂维克米纳什纳斯纳斯瓦马哈拉给我们讲解今天的大伯加瓦坦甘露早课，敬请聆听哈里克什纳。
Om Magyanatmarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksuran Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Paschanta Desantarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevata Patitanam Pavanhebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing the glories of Vrindavan described by Maharaj Parikshit to his mother, Uttara. And he's telling Maharaj Parikshit has been describing the glories of all the different people in Vrindavan. And now we were hearing about the glories of the gopis, how the gopis are the very greatest devotees. And Lord Krishna is personally describing his relationship with the gopis. Lord Krishna says that the minds of the gopis are always absorbed in thinking of him. They devote their lives to the service of Lord Krishna. And just for the sake of Krishna, they gave up everything which was connected to their bodies, even they gave up their own happiness. They even gave up the religious duties which were needed for happiness in the next life. So Lord Krishna said, I'm so much indebted to them that I take it upon myself to maintain the gopis in all circumstances.
So Krishna said, I owe them too much, so I personally承担了在所有情况下维系这些高品们的职责。
So Lord Krishna is telling this, he's telling about this to Uddhava, who is his secretary.
So Krishna 说这一番话是对他的秘书 Uddhava 所说的。
Because Lord Krishna is going to send Uddhava to Vrindavan with a message from him. So Uddhava has to take the message to Vrindavan and give it to the gopis and console the gopis.
So Krishna 将要派遣 Uddhava 去Vrindavan 捎信儿，他将会 Uddhava 将要去 Vrindavan 并且安慰 Vrindavan 的 gopis 们。
So he knows that Uddhava has to deal very carefully with the gopis. You have to console them in a very careful manner.
Uddhava 呢，必须要很小心谨慎的来，跟勾品们交往，必须要以恰当的方式来对待他们。
So Krishna also explained to him why he's so obliged to the gopis.
Krishna 也解释了为什么他，对勾品们怀着深深的亏欠之情。
And he tells Uddhava about why these gopis are the best of all devotees.
他告诉乌德瓦，这些勾品们是最伟大的奉献者的原因所在。
Because the gopis always think about Krishna, it appears, it almost appears as if they're crazy.
勾品们心意恒常挂念着关于 Krishna, 好像勾品们就有点疯疯癫癫的样子。
Because Krishna is the life and soul.Of the gopis. So wherever, whenever he goes any distance away from them, they're almost dying.
Krishna is the gopi men's life and soul. Krishna, 即便是离 gopi men 离有一点距离远了，那 gopi men 马上就处在临死的边缘。
They made great sacrifices for Krishna. They gave up the company of their husbands and their children and their homes just for Krishna. But now they're living in Vrindavan and Krishna's not there, Krishna's gone. So they feel so lost.
Gopi men 居住在 Vrindavan, 可是现在 Krishna 却离开了 Vrindavan, 所以 Gopi men 感到非常失落。
They have no other shelter than Krishna.
除了 Krishna 之外，他们再没有别的庇护了。
So we may say, well, why don't they just go to Mathura to be with Krishna? But you have to remember, Krishna promised that he would soon come back to Vrindavan. So that the gopis always remember that promise.
Gopi 们总是记着 Krishna 的这一承诺。
And they're also thinking about Krishna's happiness also.
而且他们也总是挂念着 Krishna 的快乐。
So the gopis, they don't give up their own responsibilities to their husbands and their children. They have to dress themselves nicely and put their ornaments on, which they do everything for the pleasure of Krishna.
So, 以这样一来，他们就不能放弃他们对于丈夫、孩子等等的，物质的职责，并且他们要很好的。装扮他们这样做是为了 Krishna 的快乐。
If it wasn't for Krishna's promise, the gopis would simply walk away from that. They'd just give up their homes, and they would stop dressing.They wouldn't dress themselves nicely, and they wouldn't wear any ornaments. The gopis are not attached to any of these things. Even the ornaments, the jewelry, Krishna had sent them from Mathura. Krishna had sent ornaments from Mathura to the gopis in Vrindavan, but they're not attached to these things. So the gopis of they're not thinking about their life, this life or the next life. They're only thinking about Krishna. They don't think about material happiness or spiritual happiness. So because the gopis have surrendered so perfectly to Krishna, he takes it as his duty to maintain them and to look after them. So Krishna is because of Krishna, only because of Krishna, the gopis can feel happiness. And he protects them more than their husbands. So Uddhava has to remember all this when he takes Krishna's message to Vrindavan to give to the gopis. Any devotee, it doesn't matter if they're a man or a woman, if they have pure love for Krishna, then Krishna will protect them. But the gopis, by their womanly nature, they show special qualifications that they have showed special qualifications, which is a very great sacrifice for any woman. For the sake of Krishna, they gave up their shyness and their chastity. And they gave up all their social connections just for the pleasure of Krishna. So Uddhava may be worried that the gopis, that because they're so lost without Krishna, they must be wandering about in the wilderness, just lost. So how would he be able to find them if it's like that? And if they give up all social responsibilities, and then they become like mad women, they would be like people hunted by ghosts. So if they're like that, it will be impossible for him to reason with them, to talk nicely with them.
gopi men 处在这种情况下，那 Uddhava 他就很难跟他们正常的，正常的来传话，来合情合理的跟他们交谈。
So Krishna tells Uddhava that you don't have to worry, because for Krishna's sake, although the gopis gave up their religious principles and their material happiness, Krishna watches over them and protects them.
Krishna 就向 Uddhava 保证，即便 gopi 们为了 Krishna 的缘故放弃了他们的物质快乐，那 Krishna 会关照他们，会保护他们。
So Krishna watches over them and he protects them and he provides for them. He provides all the material and spiritual benefits that they've given up.
Krishna 会照料这些 gopi 们，保护这些 gopi 们，他会给他们提供物质的快乐及灵性的幸福。而这些呢，是 gopi 们都已经抛弃了的。
So when Uddhava gets to Vrindavan, he'll see all the gopis are there at home with their husbands and children, and that they're perfectly sane.
所以当 Uddhava 到达 Vrindavan 的时候，他会发现这些 gopi 们都在家中和自己的丈夫、孩子们待在一起，而且他们都神智都是很正常、清醒的。
And Krishna also, he provides even for the husbands and the children of the gopis.
而且 Krishna 还甚至为 gopi 们的丈夫和孩子们提供他们的一切所需。
The gopis, they've mentally given up their relationship with their husband and children, but Krishna takes care of them.
Gopi 们他们已经在心意里放弃了、抛弃了他们的丈夫和孩子们，而 Krishna 是在维系着他们的丈夫和孩子。
So you don't have to worry about the families of the gopis; they're being maintained very nicely.
所以 Uddhava 无需为 gopi 们的家人而担心，他们都被好好的维系着。
And you don't have to worry that maybe the husbands have been put out of the community because their wives are not following the religious principles, so they might be put out from the community because they're acting in the wrong, in the irreligious manner. But don't worry about that, it won't happen.
而且Krishna 对 Uddhava 说，你也无需为他们的丈夫、gopi 们的丈夫而担心他们的丈夫服侍的团，因为他们的妻子们，他们从事了非宗教的活动。
Krishna is protecting the gopis. He protects the gopis' families, and he is protecting the gopis themselves and their religious principles.
Krishna 在保护着 gopi 和 gopi 的家庭，他也在保护着 gopi 本身以及他们的宗教原则。
And Krishna provides for the needs of the husbands and the children. So you can go there and you'll see how they're nicely maintained.
Krishna, 为 gopi 们的丈夫和孩子们都提供了他们所需的一切，所以 Uddhava 去那里的时候，你会看到他们都被 gopi 们都被很好的维系着。
Yeah, he provides Krishna maintains their material needs. And he maintains also their religious duties as women, which they're supposed to do.
Krishna 为他们提供了所有世俗的需求，同时 Krishna 也保护了他们作为女性的宗教职责。
And at the same time, he keeps them also engaged in their most basic interest, which is chanting of the holy names.
与此同时 ，Krishna 也让这些 gopi 们从事他们最基本的 他们的兴趣并最有兴趣的活动，那就是唱诵圣名。
Yeah, the gopis, they like to do sankirtan and chanting of the holy names, and they keep up all their devotional service where they can be serving Krishna.
Gopi 们都喜欢从事 sankirtan, 齐颂圣名，而且他们都在从事着为 Krishna 做奉爱服务。
So only for the sake of Krishna did the gopis give up their material responsibilities.
所以只是为了 Krishna, 这些 gopi 们才放弃了他们世俗的责任。
So Krishna tells Uddhava that actually he said, you are equal to me, so you should go to Braja and make the gopis happy.
Krishna 对 Uddhava 说，你事实上就跟我是一模一样的，所以你应该去 Raja 让这些 gopi 们开心快乐。
And protect the gopis' sanity and also their natural humility.
你要保护这些 gopi 们的心智，并且保护他们天然的谦卑。
And do the same thing for their husbands and their children and everybody in Raja.
你要对 gopi 们的丈夫、孩子们以及 Braja 的每一个人都一视同仁，
so、Krishna,
都这样对待他们。
Krishna tells Uddhava, he said, for the ladies, for those women of Gokula, he said, I'm the most dear object of love.
Krishna 对 Uddhava 说，对于这些 Gokula 的妇女们，我是他们最心爱的对象。
So Krishna said, when they remember me, although I'm far away, they become full of the anxiety of separation.
Krishna 说，就当这些 gopi 们想起我的时候，而我离他们是这么遥远，相隔千里，他们就会被分离的焦虑感所征服。
So Krishna is always very concerned for the gopis.
Krishna 总是关心这些 gopi 们。
He tells Uddhava he has never seen in anyone so much distress as what the gopis suffer when they're separated from him.
Krishna 告诉 Uddhava,他从来没有见过任何人像 gopi 那样在分离的情感当中如此痛苦。
It's almost like the gopis are ready to give up their bodies and go to the place of death when they feel that separation from Krishna.
当 gopi 们感受到跟 Krishna 的分离之情的时候，他们好像准备要离开他们躯体去死神的居所。
In this material world, if you have a wife or a husband, and if you have children and friends, then they're very dear to us.
在世界上，当一个人有自己的丈夫、妻子、孩子和朋友，而他们都是他们最亲爱的对象。
But our body is even more dear to us than they are.
但是比起他们而言，我们的躯体对我们更加珍贵。
And even more dear to us than the body is the air of life in the body.
而生命在躯体当中的生命之气，比躯体对我们更加珍贵。
And more dear than that is our religious principles.
而在这之上，更加珍贵的是我们的宗教原则。
And more important than that is liberation.
而比它更重要的是解脱。
And more important than liberation is Krishna bhakti, devotional service to Krishna.
比解脱更加珍贵、更加重要的是 Krishna bhakti, 对 Krishna 的纯洁的奉爱服务。
And the perfection of Krishna bhakti is when we develop love for Krishna, prema bhakti.
Krishna Bhakti 发展到顶峰, 就是最纯粹的 Prema.
So the gopis are the most advanced devotees in Krishna Prema, and that's why they're very dear to Krishna and his devotees.
而勾皮们是在 Krishna Prema 方向而念最亲近的奉献者，因此他们对于至尊主而言是最珍贵的。
Okay, for the gopis, Krishna is the most dear object of attraction.
对于勾皮们而言，Krishna是最吸引人的、最真爱的对象。
So when Krishna goes to Mathura and he remains there, then the gopis, they're full of anxiety. They feel the separation and they can almost, it's hard for them to stay alive.
当Krishna远离，他交去了Mathura的时候，gopis们几乎就在分离的焦虑当中，几乎就淹没在这个漩涡当中。他们只是希望Krishna回来，所以才活着。Yeah,
the only reason they stay alive is the hope that Krishna will come back to them.
勾皮们活下去的唯一的理由就是
And when they're feeling that separation from Krishna, then it's difficult for them to act and to think. It's almost like they're insane.
当勾皮们处在这种分离情感当中的时候，他们几乎是无法思考、无法行动，就好像他们神志不正常了。
And they begin to remember, when they begin to remember about Krishna, when he was with them, how he used to associate with them. And it becomes difficult for them to understand that they're actually still alive.
他们甚至都很难来想着自己还活着。
If Krishna will leave them even for a moment, it's difficult for the gopis.
Krishna离开勾皮，哪怕只有片刻，勾皮们都觉得难以忍受。
But when Krishna leaves Vrindavan for Mathura, just a minute. When he leaves from Vrindavan for Mathura, then that's the greatest distress for them.
When Krishna leaves Vrindavan to Mathura, for the gopis, it's the most painful situation.
So even though they're in so much pain from separation from Krishna, they cannot stop thinking of Krishna.
即便是勾皮们感受到跟Krishna分离的巨大痛楚，他们仍然是止不住，还是想念Krishna。
So Krishna tells Uddhava, he reminds Uddhava, he said, I am depending on your skills as a messenger and counselor to save the lives of the gopis.
Krishna tells Uddhava, 说，我现在完全依赖你的技巧，你作为一个信使，能够，并且作为一个顾问，能够拯救这些勾皮们的生命。
And Krishna gave the letter, he wrote a letter for the gopis, gave it to Uddhava to deliver to the gopis.
Krishna 就写下了一封信，交给Uddhava，转交给这些勾皮们。
So Krishna says, He said, I promise to return to the gopis. I promised my girlfriends that somehow I asked them somehow or other to maintain their lives, and I would come back to them.
Krishna 就说，我曾经就向这些gopi们保证，说我会回到他们身边。我对我的这些女朋友们，他们在努力的在维持他们生命的这些女朋友们，曾经答应过他们。
So we've been hearing about the condition of all the ladies in Vrindavan. All the ladies means old ladies as well as young ladies. They were all devoted to Krishna. But he knows that of all the gopis, the ones who are most dear to him are the young gopis, such as Sri Radhika.
Krishna 深知，在所有的这些gopi们当中，他最珍爱的是那些年轻的gopi，比如说Sri Radhika.
So, Krishna knows that these girlfriends of his, who include also gopis like Chandravali, that when he leaves them, they're almost dying in separation.
Krishna 知道，这些年轻的gopi，包括Chandravali, 当 Krishna 离他们远去之际，他们几乎就要死去了。
So Krishna is ashamed to admit, but he intends to tell a lie to the gopis.
Krishna 虽然很不好意思承认，但是他有点他想要对gopi们撒谎。
He has to explain about what the message he's written to them is about.
他必须要向他们解释他在信中给他们的内容。And
Uddhava, he has to assure the gopis that Krishna will come back to them very soon.
Uddhava 必须要向gopi们保证，Krishna很快就会回来。So
this will keep the gopis alive. They won't die if they know that.
如果gopi们知道这一点的话，他们就不会死去了。
So, previously, Akrura had taken Krishna and Balaram away from Gokula. So, that at that time, the message saved them from death.
之前，当Akrura把Krishna和Balarama从Gokula带走的时候， Krishna 捎给牧牛姑娘的消息，拯救了牧牛姑娘一命。
At that time, Krishna told them, he made a promise that he would return after only a few days.
那一次， Krishna 向牧牛姑娘们保证，过几天就会回来。
So the simple people of Vrindavan, they had faith in Krishna's words. So they were able to tolerate Krishna leaving them for some time. Because they thought, well, he's coming back very soon, so it's okay. That if he's coming back in a few days, then it's all right. Let him go. We know he's going to come back to us.
对这些文达文的人们，他们知道 Krishna 只会离开几天而已，他
So Krishna is aware that gopis like Radhika, Sri Radhika, they dedicated their life to Krishna, only to Krishna, to nobody else. So he's telling Uddhava about this.
Krishna 深知, 像 Radhika 这样的勾皮们, 他们已经把他们的生命 只献给了 Krishna, 所以他就向乌德华解释了这一点。
So it's only by the special efforts of Krishna that they can stay alive and keep their souls in their bodies.
只是由于 Krishna的特殊的努力, 所以他们才
The gopis are burning in the fire of separation, but Krishna is struggling to save them. So most of the gopis, somehow they managed to survive, but some of them already died. Haribo. Huh? Okay. Haribo. Sorry, somebody here. Okay. So some of them died, and others, they will also be lost. Some other gopis, they will also be lost in the fire of separation. They will also die. So it's more and more difficult for them to stay alive because of the separation, the pain of separation. So only by the shelter of Krishna's power are the gopis surviving. But Krishna doesn't want to admit this to Uddhava. Because Uddhava may say, well, why you keep them alive like this? It's not fair. But if Krishna was to allow the gopis to leave their bodies, their suffering would end. But because Krishna is keeping them alive, so he's intensifying, just continuing their pain and suffering. But there's another point also we have to understand, and that is that Krishna will share the fate of the gopis. So Krishna needs to be saved as much as the gopis need to be saved. So Uddhava should be very careful, very serious in his mission. He has to bring the gopis a message of hope.
So Uddhava 对他的使命一定要非常的严肃认真,
Because devotees are suffering on account for when the devotees hear about the gopis suffering, then this also affects the devotees. How does Krishna plan to maintain the gopis' lives? Because Krishna said that he's promised that he will maintain the gopis through all the difficulties. All, any difficulties they have, Krishna will help them to overcome the problems. So Krishna, somehow or other, he arranges for the gopis' happiness. So Krishna tells Uddhava how he can help. So when he meets the gopis, he has to bring Krishna's message, promising that Krishna is going to return very soon. Although it's almost impossible to save the gopis, but if they get this message that Krishna is coming back, then it might keep their life in their body. They may keep their life in their bodies. So Uddhava should visit the gopis and convince them that Krishna is coming back.
He's
already on the way. He's almost here.
Krishna 已经在路上了，他几乎就快到了。
In this way, he can encourage the gopis to stay alive. So the people of Vrindavan, which means especially the gopis, they had so much love for Krishna. So when Krishna says, when my uncle Akrura, when he came and brought Balaram and Krishna to Mathura, then the people of Vrindavan, they suffered the separation. They could not find any happiness. There was no happiness for them, seeing Krishna leave them. When Krishna and Uddhava were together in Dwarka, Krishna told Uddhava the value of associating with devotees. So when Krishna was discussing this topic, then he was reminded of the greatest devotees, the gopis of Vrindavan.
当 Krishna 讨论到这个话题的时候，他就联想到了最伟大的奉献者，就是那些 gopis 们。
So this inspired Krishna to speak more about the gopis.
这就让 Krishna 有更多的动力来谈论 gopi 们。
And we're told how Kamsa, he had sent Akrura to bring Krishna to Mathura. Krishna was not very eager to make the trip, but Akrura was very cunning to convince Krishna and Balaram that going to Mathura was necessary.
Krishna 本身并不想去，他踏上这个，但是 Akrura 他非常狡猾，他就说服了 Krishna 和 Balarama， 告诉他们这次旅行是必要的。
So Krishna wants that the people of Vrindavan have to excuse Akrura for taking him away.
Krishna 希望 Vrindavan 的人们原谅 Akrura 把他带走。
And Krishna told them that Akrura was only doing what he thought was his duty, because he thought by taking Krishna away, he would protect the dynasty from the anger of Kamsa.
Akrura 毕竟只是履行职责而已，他只是想着要保护他的王朝免于 Kamsa 的愤怒。
Now, when Akrura came to Vrindavan, Balaram was present. And Balaram could have pacified the Brijbasis.
When Akrura came to Vrindavan, Balarama was there. Balarama could have pacified the Brijbasis.
Previously, when Krishna was in the grip of Kaliya, serpent, at that time, Balarama pacified the minds of all the people of Vrindavan, because they all thought the Kaliya serpent's going to kill Krishna. They were all dying, but Balaram told them, no, it's okay.
以前，当 Krishna 在 Kaliya 蛇的紧紧的缠绕当中，巴拉拉玛就安慰了所有的文达文的居民，就向他们保证 Krishna 会安然无恙的。
But this time, Balarama, this time with Akrura coming, Balaram didn't say anything.
但是这一次，当 Akrura 到来之际，巴拉拉玛什么话都没有说。
And Akrura was speaking about the position of Vasudeva and Devaki and the other people of the Yadu dynasty, how they were all living in fear and misery under the Kamsa.
Akrura
在
跟 Akrura 就讲述了 Vasudeva, Devaki 和其他王朝当中的人们，他们处在巨大的恐惧当中和巨大的痛苦当中。
So when Balaram heard this, he gave permission for Krishna to go to Mathura and to leave Vrindavan.
当 Balarama 听了这番处境之后，他就允许 Krishna 离开 Vrindavan 去 Mathura。
If Balaram hadn't have said anything, Krishna may never have left Vrindavan.
Krishna
So after Krishna left Vrindavan, the gopis had no more, they had nothing, no pleasure. There was no pleasure in their life anymore. Everything they saw just only reminded them that Krishna had gone and left them and made them more miserable. So everything they saw, it just appeared to have no value anymore because Krishna had gone. And it made it impossible for them to enjoy anything in life. So when Krishna was with them, the gopis were very, very attached to Krishna.
When Krishna was with them,
but now that Krishna had gone, they were even more attached to Krishna. And it was like the separation, which was a type of ecstasy, was even greater. Nothing was able to give them any happiness. Now, Uddhava is very intelligent. He's a disciple of Brihaspati, so he's very, very learned, and he considered the situation. So Uddhava wondered why the gopis would be so attracted to Krishna when he caused them so much pain. So Krishna's answer is that the gopis' love for him was so intense that nothing, not even Krishna's bad treatment of them, could stop them from loving Krishna. Right. When Krishna was away from them, separated them for even a moment, it would be like millions of years to them. The gopis protected their senses. The gopis protected their senses by keeping them away from material objects. And so they were actually great yogis, can control their senses. But Krishna was so attractive that their love for him, they could not stop their love for him. So there's Madhusudan. Madhusudan is a name of Krishna. It's also the name of a type of bee, which always collects honey from many lotus flowers. So Krishna took from the gopis, Krishna, who is also Madhusudan, he took from the gopis and ruined all their honey. He took away all their good qualities. He stole everything they had. So Krishna told Uddhava, he said, it's just my nature to attract all kinds of people and to exploit them for my own pleasure. And then I enjoy them to my fullest extent. After I enjoy them, I go away and leave them miserable. So this Krishna was instructing Uddhava to carry this message to the gopis.
Krishna 就告诉 Uddhava 把这个信息烧给gopis们。
And he wants the gopis to know that he also feels pain in separation from the gopis, just as they are in pain in separation from him.
Krishna 想要告诉这些gopis们，就像他们感受到与 Krishna 的分离之苦， Krishna 也感觉到跟gopis们的分离之苦。
But the gopis surrendered to Krishna with full dedication for him. But Krishna, he's not nearly as surrendered to them as they are to him. So Krishna may have a good reputation as the best of saintly persons.
Krishna 也许以最优秀的圣人而享誉世界。
But actually, in Krishna's opinion, Krishna thinks the gopis are much more virtuous than he is. In the gopis, there's no sign of cruelty. And there's no ingratitude, being ungrateful. There's not this ungrateful nature in the gopis. So the pure love of the gopis is not to be found anywhere else.
So,
Okay, so we'll stop.
好，那我们政治部分讲到这里。来回答问题。第一个问题是 ，Lila Shakti Devadasi， 礼拜 Guru Day， 礼拜奉献者。我的问题是，任何怎样理解任何一个在 Mathura、Vrindavan、Navadvipa 这些地方旅行奉献服务的人，离开区以后必重返家园回归守神？这是法坛10.1.28要旨当中一段话。Lila Shakti paid obeisance to devotees. Her questions are how to understand anybody who have performed devotional service in any of the places like Mathura, Vrindavan, Navadvipa. After leaving their body, they will surely return back home, back to Godhead. This is the purport from Bhagavatam 10.Canto 10, Chapter 1, Verse 28. Purport.
Yes. How to understand this?
Yes.
Anybody who performs devotional service and leave their body in Vrindavan will go back to Godhead.
Either Mathura or Vrindavan or Navadvipa.
Yeah. But that's the power of the Holy Dham.
这就是圣地的力量。
It's very special to be able to leave your body in the Holy Dham.
能在圣地离开躯体，这是非常特殊的。
But it's also special to leave your body in the association of devotees.
但是在奉献者的联谊当中离开躯体是更加特殊的情况。
The association of the devotees is that makes the place a holy dham.
正是在与奉献者的联谊，这个联谊上使一个使一个地方变成了圣地。
Wherever the devotees are, that is a holy place.
无论哪里有奉献者，哪里就是圣地。
So you get the same benefit if you leave the body with the devotees, where the devotees are chanting the holy name. It's very powerful.
所以如果在奉献者唱诵圣名的地方能够离开躯体，那会得到像在圣地离开躯体一样的好处。
So we encourage all the devotees, you know, that we play the chanting box. We hear Prabhupada chanting the holy name, and we have pictures of Krishna in our house, and like that.Our home is like a holy place.
So, we encourage 奉献者们把圣帕帕德的唱诵机播放圣帕帕德的唱诵，还有在房间里摆放 Krishna 的画像，那么这个家呢就变成了圣地了。
All right.
下一个问题。Raja Rani Devadasi, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微。Lila Shakti said us, I know that, thank you, good day.
Okay, so did I answer her question then?
Yes, she said, understand, thank you. No. 那 Lila Shakti, 那回答您的问题了是吧？Raja Rani, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微的顶拜，所有荣耀归于舍利弗，感恩您给我们讲仁慈的讲课。我们不能像勾皮那样放弃我们的物质职责、家庭，怎么办？怎样能学习勾皮们的意识？我们的物质职责也放弃不了，但是他们没完没了。谢谢。 Vavragami said, thank you so much for your merciful lecture to us. We cannot give up our material duty and family like Gopi. So what to do? How can we learn the consciousness of Gopi? We cannot give up our material duties, and they are endless.
So the gopis, they didn't give up any of their duties either. We explained, the gopis didn't give up any of their duties, but they were always chanting the holy name of Krishna, and they were always remembering Krishna. So this is the secret of the gopis. If you want to follow the gopis, you have to constantly chant the holy name and remember Krishna in your mind. And the gopis, they had husbands and children. But they didn't leave them, they didn't give up their duties, but at the same time, they understood everything in relation to Krishna. They did everything to please Krishna, because they knew that Krishna would be pleased if they did these duties. And if they gave up these duties, then Krishna would not be pleased with
them.
So you have to do your duty because Krishna wants you to do it. You do it for the pleasure of Krishna.
Yes. Next one? Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and dear devotees, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Did Uddhava somehow change after his association with the gopis? Did his service to Krishna change? Thank you. 这是 Yuna, 她说, Yuna 说, 所以荣耀归于帕帕奉献者咕噜, Uddhava 在和勾皮们联谊之后有没有改变呢? 他对 Krishna 的服务有变化吗?
Yeah, Krishna became a follower of the gopis. He followed in the footsteps of the gopis. He understood that how the gopis are the greatest devotees of Krishna. So he certainly, when he brought the message to the gopis and he met the gopis and he saw how they were living, then he was so impressed. He thought, oh, it's so wonderful. So he prayed that in his next birth, he could somehow get the association of these people.
Did his service to Krishna, did Uddhava's service to Krishna change? She asked.
Did Uddhava's service to Krishna change? Well, so long as Krishna was present in the planet, Uddhava was with him.
Krishna 在哪个星球上 Uddhava 总是和 Krishna 在一起。
When Krishna left the world, he told Uddhava he had to stay. He told Uddhava, you can't go yet, you have to stay.
当 Krishna 离开这星球的时候 ，Krishna 告诉 Uddhava 要留下来，他不能走。
So Uddhava came and he lived in Vrindavan.
So Uddhava came and
he lived in Vrindavan.
So 后来 Uddhava 就来居住在 Vrindavan 了。
There's a, when you go around Govardhan Hill, there's one temple there, and there's a Uddhava Kund is there.We have the lake where Uddhava used to sit, just beside the Govardhan Hill. Just before you get to Radha Kund, when you're coming around the Govardhan Hill, so just before you get back to Radha Kund, there's a temple there, it's called Uddhava. Uddhava Kund is there, and Uddhava used to stay there at that place.
就是到达 Radha Kund 之前，有一个 Uddhava 庙，那里又有个 Uddhava Kund。Uddhava 以前呢，就坐在这个地方，就在山高尔的山旁边。瞧一下。
OK。
下一个是真真 Hare Krishna， 亲爱的妈 Guru Maharaj。请接受我卑微的顶拜，一切荣耀归于圣人帕帕的顶拜，所有奉献者啊，在奉爱服务当中念诵、唱诵、阅读《博伽梵歌》《博伽瓦坛》和奉献者联谊，服务奉献者，崇拜神像，和奉献者讨论 Krishna 消时光，聆听帕布帕的讲课和领导的讲课，哪些最能培养对 Krishna 的奉爱之情？重点先后顺序是什么？Chen Chen, said that the dear Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. So among the devotional service like chanting, hearing, reading Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, association with devotees, serve devotee, worship deity, discuss Krishna's pastime with devotee, listening to lecture of the Prabhupada and spiritual masters, which one?And cultivate the devotional mood to Krishna best. What's the sequence of the priority of those devotional service?
So the first thing is to chant the holy name.
第一件事是唱诵圣名。
Right, you must chant at least 16 rounds.
您必须至少每天念诵16天。
And then you can do any of these other things.
然后唱念完十六圈，您就可以做任何其他的服务了。
But chanting of the holy name is the most important thing in the Kali Yuga.
但是唱诵圣名是在卡里年代最重要的事情。
Because it's only by chanting the holy name that we can go back to Godhead.
因为只有透过唱诵圣名，我们才能回归神手。
Of course, they're all good things. Everything you mentioned is good, but you have to do the chanting of the holy name.
当然您说的这些服务都很好，但是您必须要唱诵圣名。
That's the most important.
这是最重要的服务。
The first business of the devotee is to chant the holy name.
奉献者的首要事务是念诵主的圣名。
Okay.
下一个是 Shruti Rupa Devadasi, Hare Krishna, 顶拜孤儒和老师们。有新人在看了连续剧《Mahabharata》之后提问。为什么那个仇恨Bhishma的公主在选择自杀之后没有去地狱，反而是投生 Hare Krishna, there are new fights after watching the TV series Mahabharata. He or she raised the question that Amba, that the prince who hates Bhishma, after she chose to commit suicide, she didn't went to the hell. But she took birth as a warrior who can remember her past life and in the next life return to kill Bhishma. So what's your opinion about this event? What should we say this event?
Well, it's mundane. What can we say? It's not anything to do with devotional service.
这是世俗的,
simply we're hearing about a woman who's very attached to some man. She wanted to marry some man. And because she didn't get her way, then she took so much trouble. So it's not something, it's not an incident which is very much important for devotees. There's no Krishna bhakti, there's no devotion to Krishna. But we see Bhishma is very determined. He made a vow to remain brahmachari, and even though the woman wanted, he was supposed to marry the woman, and even his guru tried to get him to marry the girl, Bhishma wouldn't give up his vow. He kept his vow. He made a vow not to marry. He had promised his father he would not marry, so he kept that promise.
我们看到在这件事情当中呢，Bhishma，就是发誓，他下决心不娶任何，他保持真守，终生真守。即便那个女子想要嫁，他本来他应该理应去娶那个女子，而且他的姑姑也命令他娶她，但是Bhishma没有放弃自己真守的誓言。 他因为他向父亲曾经做过发过誓，所以他就终身的遵守。
Okay, next question.
下一个，also from Shruti Rupa， 还有年轻人问，既然 Krishna 会派奉献者来人世间传播真理，为什么恶魔不会代表？ 不会派代表来人间兴风作浪呢? There are new young people who raised the question that since Krishna can send devotees to this world to spread the absolute truth, why not then the demons? Why cannot the demons also send their representatives to this world to make troubles?
Well, they do.
他们派遣了。
Yeah, they send their demons. They send other demons here to give us trouble. There's a lot of them. They get big power, they get positions, sometimes they're big politicians. Sometimes they're scientists, sometimes they're philosophers. They speak a lot of atheistic philosophy. Yeah, there are many, many demons. Okay.
现在的疫情是不是能力很大的？ 外星球恶魔和人类中的高智商团伙合作搞出来的？ 请问如果是这样， 他们到底是邪恶的罪犯， 还是以Krishna的奉献者身份 来消灭我们这些不合格的人类， 净化地球的呢？ Ganguru. Whether or not this epidemic is made by those people from the outer space, from those demons from outer space, cooperated with some human who have high intelligence, they are cooperated to make this pandemic disease. If it is so, this is the first part of the question.
Yes, possible.
可能是的, 有可能.
Demons made this disease to kill many people and to give a lot of trouble to the world.
恶魔们制造了这场疾病， 杀死了许多的人类， 制造了许多的麻烦。 Whether they are evil criminal or they are devotee of Krishna to kill kill those human beings, unqualified human beings, to purify the earth.
Yes, that's also true. That is purifying the earth by this disease. You can see a lot of things have become purified because of the pandemic. Just like the water of the Yamuna used to be very polluted, but since the pandemic, the water of the Yamuna has become much nicer.
地球得到很大的净化，羊的河水以前是污染的，但是现在呢，羊的河水的情况好多了。Yes,
so the world is getting purified because less people were traveling less and airplanes were not flying so much, so there was a lot less pollution.
世界呢，现在变得干净了，因为那个人们 不再有熙熙攘攘的旅行，天上的飞机也少了，所以就污染就少了。
And people can lead a more natural, peaceful life.
人们的生活更加贴近于自然平和。People
were staying at home more, so people would be with their families more. That's good.
人们更多的时间要回到自己的家中。 和他们的家人共处， 这很好。
So there's a lot of benefits from the pandemic.
So 疫情, 带来很多好处.
Mm-hmm.
下一个是文言, 顶拜 Guru, 家里摆放 Krishna 的照片, 在家里念诵, 家就是圣地, 那么做家务, 收拾家里, 卫生, 就相当于打扫圣地, 可以这么理解吗?
Yes, you can. Very good. You should think like that. Okay, next question.
This devotee paid obeisance to you and all devotees. The gopis' love is the purest love, the highest love. But then in our practical life, can we cultivate such kind of love? Because it seems that I cannot really love myself, love my family members. I cannot do it well. So it seems that it's very difficult to attain such pure and noble love.
Yes, it takes some time. We have to hear about it more, and gradually, gradually, we can purify ourselves and come to that level.
是的，但是它是需要时间的。 我们应该越更多的聆听, 然后得到净化, 达到这样的层面。
We know in the beginning it's not easy. It's not easy for us. We're all conditioned souls. So we don't have pure love. We have to come to that level.
一开始并不容易, 因为我们是很受条件限制的。 我们没有那么进化，但是我们必须要进化，然后我们达到这样的，努力达到这种层面。
Yeah.
下一个, Surabhi. Hare Krishna, dear Maharaj, may I ask you a question related to Diksha Guru? As we know, nowadays some devotees have first and second or sannyasi initiation from different spiritual masters. Does this mean that in a sense they have two or three Diksha Gurus in their spiritual life instead of only one Diksha Guru? Thank you, Maharaj. Thank you, sir. Swabhivan, Hare Krishna, 亲爱的 Maharaj, 我可以问一个关于启迪孤的问题。我们知道现在有些奉献者 他们从不同的灵性导师那里得到了一次启迪、二次启迪和Sannyasi启迪，是不是这意味着他们有两位Diksha Guru或三位Diksha Guru就在他们灵性生活当中，而不是只有一位启迪Guru呢？非常感谢您。
Well, the procedure is the person who gives you first initiation should be the one to give you second initiation. You don't take the second initiation from a different guru unless the person who gave you first initiation leaves the body.
程序是这样的，那个给了您一次启迪的guru，他理应给您二次启迪，不应该是不同的guru，但是。
Now the person who gives you sannyas, that's not guru, that's not Diksha Guru. He's just giving you sannyas, he's just giving you that, he's just doing that ceremony. But he's not becoming your guru.
而给予一个人sannyas启迪的不是guru。
So Diksha Guru is one. You get one Diksha Guru. You may not be able to complete the second initiation. You may have to take from someone else. The person who gave you first initiation may leave the body. But still the person who gives you first initiation, he is the Diksha Guru. Now it's up to you. If you want to take the person who gave you second initiation as your Diksha Guru, you can also do it. You can worship both.
So the first initiation guru is the Diksha Guru. If she wants to take the second initiation guru as the Diksha Guru, that is also okay, right?
The first initiation is the main initiation. By the first initiation, you can go back to Godhead. Is that okay, Surabhi? If you have any more, if there's any more doubt, you can ask. Okay. Yes, if your living room is a good place, that big place, then you can do it.
可以，如果您的客厅是一个不错的地方，可以。
But you have to consider who comes to your home. You have to consider what kind of people are coming to your home. Are they going to ask, what is this? Why you put this person's picture on your wall? Who is he? Are you comfortable with that? Is it not going to be difficult for you? Because they're obviously going to wonder, what is this? Why you put these pictures on your wall? And it may bring you some difficulties. So be careful.
就是来客厅的客人的情况，什么样的人会来到客厅？他们会不会问这些问题？那这照片上是谁呀？为什么你要摆放在墙上啊？那如果您听到这个问题的时候，您心里会不会感到舒服？会不会难以回答这些问题的话？那如果很困难的话，那你就得小心了。
Okay.
下一个玄心瓶。明白孤乳，明白孙奉献者，答案，请问怎么起玄心瓶 ？Ask how to get diksha.
How to get diksha?
Initiation. Yes.
You have to get recommendation from a devotee, from a senior devotee who is initiated.
您必须得到一位已经启迪了的年长的奉献者的推荐。
In different cities, in different places, different people are given the responsibility to recommend others for initiation.
在不同的 ，Yes, Maharaj, I can hear you.
Okay.
Hare Krishna. 那在不同的城市、不同的地方，就有不同的人，他们肩负着推荐启迪新人的责任。
So you have to find out who's responsible, who's got that duty to recommend people for initiation.And you have to ask them, are you qualified for initiation? The one who wants initiation has to ask the person who's recommending for initiation. You have to ask them, am I qualified for initiation?
那么您找到这样的一位推荐人之后呢，您必须得问这个有资格来推荐，就是推荐人，向他问，那我现在够不够资格，获得启迪呢？
Qualification is that you're very strictly following the four regulative principles and chanting 16 rounds every day.
那得到启迪的资格就是严格遵守四项规范原则，每天念诵十六圈。
Now sometimes it's difficult for people, you know, if you have a job and you have to go to work every day, then it's difficult to get time to do chanting.
对有的人来说呢，就觉得就是有困难，他们要工作，要上班，他们找不出时间来念诵。
We don't, you know, if you have to work all day and you come home at night late and you must be tired after working all day, then if you didn't chant in the morning, then it's difficult to chant at night.
倘若一个人一整天都在外面上班，然后等到晚上了，很疲累的才回到家，他们早上不能早上念诵，他们晚上就很难念诵。
So you should think carefully, you know, about initiation before you think about taking initiation. First of all, be sure.That you can do it without too much difficulty.
在您考虑启迪这件事之前呢，您必须要做好充分的准备。您必须要确保，就是念诵对您来说不是一件难事。
Okay.
下一个，巴提。顶拜孤乳，所有奉献者的莲花族，请问孤乳：一，绕灯时绕 Krishna 4237后还绕亚瑟的吗？绕几圈呢？神坛所有照片都绕吗？绕完涟漪，绕完还要绕涟漪的奉献者吗？绕完的灯是放在 Damodar 照片前吗？感恩。Bhakti is wondering about the procedure of the offering lamb to Damodar. So after we offer the lambs to Lord Damodar, 4, 2, 3, 7 rounds to different part of the body. Should we offer the lamp to Yashoda mother? And how many rounds should we offer the lamp? And should we offer the lamp to all the picture on the altar? And after that, to also offer the lamp to the assembled devotee? And what about the lamp? After the offering, should we put the lamp in front of the Damodar? Thank you.
Yes, usually after the offering, we'll put the lamp in front of Damodar.
是的,灯一般供奉之前呢,要放在达摩达尔面前。And
yes, you can offer, once you offer to Damodar and Mother Yashoda, you can offer to the other pictures if you want, you don't have to.
那在您把灯绕完达摩达尔之后呢,可以绕亚瑟的妈妈,然后就是神坛上其他的照片呢,可绕可不绕。
Yeah, it's up to every individual how you feel devoted and how you feel inspired, what you want to do. The main thing is to offer the lamp to Krishna.
这就是取决于自己个人，您内心呢有什么样的动力，有什么样的灵感激励，您有什么想法。 最主要的是给Krishna供灯。下一个，Sitarani，礼拜Guru。现在疫情去不了圣地，是不是也制造了另外一种分离的情感？尽管唱诵圣名的地方就是圣地，仍然想念圣地，想念Guru，想念圣地居民的大眼睛。 Sitarani said, although we cannot go to the Holy Dham during the pandemic, is that to create a mood of separation and us? Although wherever there are the Holy Name, it is the Holy Dham, but still we miss the Holy Dham, we miss Guru, we miss the big eyes of the Holy Dham, Rajabasi. Of the Basi in the Holy Dham. Dham Basi.
Yes. Well, yes, just like you're missing the Holy Dham and the spiritual teachers, so spiritual teachers also missing the devotees. The Holy Dham is also missing the devotees.
是的，正像您想念圣地，想念灵性老师。 林永老师呢，也想念您，圣地也思念您。
So it's a mutual feeling of separation.
这个分离的情感呢，是互相的。But
by thinking and remembering each other, then we are together in our hearts.
但是呢，通过意念彼此，想念着彼此。
And there's always the hope that in the future we'll be together again.
而且就是总是有那样，就是总是希望着将来我们会再次重逢。
Just like the gopis, they're thinking Krishna's going to come back sometime. So we're also thinking in the future. We have the opportunity to be with the devotees again.
就像Gopi们寄希望于Krishna总有一天会回来，所以我们也希望将来会有机会和奉献者们重逢。No more Krishna.
Okay.
No, there is one more. Chandra Sundar, 顶拜Guru，请问我回来福建福鼎老家三年了，跟身边所有佛教徒相处，大家对我个人吃全素认可。 但是我跟有缘的佛教徒讲 Krishna， 大家没听说过，就我一个人信。还有人说我独创宗教，如何跟非奉念人解释呢？ Chandra Sundari pay a listen to you, and she report that she had return back to the Fujian province, the holy hometown. It's 3 years, and the Buddhists around her accept that she is a pure vegetarian. But when she talked about Krishna to Buddhists, some Buddhists, they have never heard about Krishna, and only her alone believe in Krishna. Even somebody said that it is created by this religion is created by her. So how can she ask, how can she explain Krishna to non-devotees?
Well, we have books. One thing you can do is give them a book to read.
我们有书籍，您可以给他们做的一件事，为他们做的一件事就是给他们书籍看。
And you show them the book like Bhagavad Gita, and you show them that this book is from Sanskrit, and it was spoken 5,000 years ago.
您可以拿国家梵歌给他们看，告诉他们这部国家梵歌原本是用梵文写成的，是5000年前讲述的。
It's a very famous book, and many Buddhist monks, they also read that book.
这部书非常有名，有许多佛教徒都读这本书。
It's only one book, but there are many other books which are also from the Vedas. And the Vedas are all ancient scriptures in Sanskrit language, which was long before Buddhism.
除了国家梵歌之外，还有浩如烟海的韦达经。韦达经是非常古老的典籍，是用梵文写成的。它比佛教要历史古老的多。
So you can let them have the book. You can also teach them the mantra. You can teach them about chanting the Maha Mantra, and tell them this is a mantra, special sound vibration, which helps us to control the mind and senses.
您可以教他们念这个 Maha Mantra， 告诉他们这个特殊的音阵可以控制我们的感官，控制我们的心意。
Tell them about the powerful effect of the sound vibration.
告诉他们这个音阵的特殊的能量。
So many Buddhist monks, they also like to absorb their mind in meditation on a sound vibration. So you can tell them they should meditate on this mantra.
有许多佛教徒热衷于将心意专注去冥想，一种音阵，您可以告诉他们，让他们冥想这首 mantra。
But you should also explain, we are not trying to become Krishna. We are the servant of Krishna. Krishna is the master, and we are the servant.
但是您要跟他们解释清楚，我们不是为了成为 Krishna， 我们是 Krishna 的仆人。Krishna 是主人，我们是仆人。
But before you explain about Krishna, before you explain Krishna, first you should explain about the soul. Tell them we're not the body.
当您向他们解释 Krishna 之前，您要告诉他们，您要解释灵魂，告诉他们解释我们不是躯体。
You have to teach them, just like we change the dress, we change the body.
您要教他们，就我们换躯体就像换衣服一样。
So you can read from the Bhagavad Gita, you can read from the second chapter about the soul. You can begin from text number 11, 12. You can read to them for about 10, 20 verses. You can read about the soul.
从第二章的世界十七、十一开始给他们读十个世界或二十个世界，这些世界都是讲述有关灵魂的。
So try to teach them like that, that you're not the body, you're a soul. Then, after they understand they're not the body, they're a soul, then you can explain to them something about the soul.
你就这样教他们，他们不是他们的身体，而是灵魂。在他们明白灵魂这件事之后，再给他们讲至尊灵魂。No，我没有说至尊经文，
我说 just to explain something about the soul. You see, Buddhist people, Buddhists are all atheists. They don't believe in God. So it's difficult for them to understand Krishna consciousness.
佛教是无神论的，他们不相信、不承认神的存在，给他们解释Krishna之觉是很难的一件事。
So first you teach them about the soul.
所以首先您要教他们有关灵魂这件事。
The nature of the soul, that the soul is eternal and never dies.
灵魂的本性是什么? 灵魂是永恒的，是无生无死的。
We change the body, we give up one body, but the soul goes from one body to another body, takes a new body.
我们改灵魂，改变躯体，从一个躯体轮回到下一个躯体。 Is Draupadi the expansion of a goddess fortune?
Is Draupadi an expansion of the goddess of fortune?
Yes.
I don't know about that. I've never heard that. I heard she came from the heavenly planets.
我听说她是来自天堂星球的。Of
course, she's a great devotee.
她当然是伟大的奉献者。But
I heard she came from the heavenly planets.
但是我听说她是从天堂来的。Yeah. 所以Draupadi has suffered a lot. Is that because the curse when her father performed yagya? Is that her misery is due to the curse while her father is performing the fire yagya?
I don't know what curse you're talking about.
我不知道您说的诅咒是什么。
Her father was Maharaj Draupada. Right, so he did a yajna to get a son who would kill Drona. So at that time he got a son, Dhrishtadyumna, and he also got a daughter. They both came from the fire, from the yajna. So Draupadi, she took birth from the sacrificial fire, not an ordinary birth. Draupadi did that. He wanted to get revenge on Drona, so he did a yajna to get a son to kill Drona. And Draupadi also took birth at that time. And Draupadi, of course, she was the cause of the battle of Kurukshetra. Yeah, one of the main causes of the Battle of Kurukshetra was the bad treatment of Draupadi, that she'd been insulted.
In Mahabharata, it described that about one to I'm not so clear about her question. Mahabharata described that want to marry Arjuna's daughter. Which statement is correct? I'm not so sure about what she's talking about. 你能不能再具体的讲一下吧题? 对不起。
Arjuna's daughter.
Yeah, about Mary.
I never heard about anything about Arjuna's daughter. I don't know. I know Arjuna, he had four wives, right? The main wife was, Draupadi was one wife, so he had a son by her. The five Pandavas each had a son by Draupadi, and they were killed by Ashwatthama. And then Arjuna also married Subhadra, who was Krishna's Balaram's sister.
Arjuna 还娶了 Subhadra. Subhadra 是 Krishna 和 Balaram 的妹妹.
So there were two other wives, Chitrangada and Ulupi. They were also wives of Arjuna.
还有两个妻子, Chitrangada 和 Ulupi. 他们是 Arjuna 的另外两个妻子.
But I never heard about his daughter, him having a daughter. I don't know.
Maybe her question is that Draupada wants a daughter who can marry Arjuna.
Who? Draupadi wants a daughter who could marry Arjuna?
Maharaj Draupada wants
oh.
who could get a daughter who can marry Arjuna.
Really?
Surabhi said.
Oh.
And Surabhi said, thank you, Maharaj, for your very clear explanation.
Okay. Okay, Maharaj Draupadi wanted a daughter who could marry Arjuna. I never heard that before. Okay, so that's new for me. Thank you.
Okay, that's all the question.
Okay, so we'll stop here. Thank you very much. Wamangetshi Guru Maniki, Wamangjangtai De Fun E, Wamangetshi Soyo De Fung Shenzi Ling Ting, Tiwen, Wamangjufu Niman, Changchong Kwaila, Damodar Yu Kwaila, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Jai.
Go back to Vrinda Ki.
Jai.
Haribol.